try jumping down from here?
Hey, look!
It's acting strange. He must be weak from losing his tail.
Yeah, that looks plenty feisty to me.
He's bluffing to scare us off. Let's just go with that, all right? Come on, we can do this.
We are free. We go now to hunt down evil where it hides.
So I guess that means there are still more monsters like that one out there.
Sounds like it. Somewhere out there on Grand Pulse.
Gone just like that. Big hunk of rock, that thing sure can move.
Guess they're just doing what they can too. Trying to save the world.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, it's not all on them. Last time I checked, we are still in this fight.
Erebus right down there then, isn't it?
Yep.
So what's it like?
Well, it's kind of small.
but it's warm and green and very naturey.
Around the Thal Sea, it was flowers as far as you could see, huh?
View from here? Ain't so rosy, I'm sorry to say.
You want to wait here?
No. I need to see for myself. It's all gone.
Every trace of color. We're chasing shadows. This whole idea of losing our brands is hopeless.
There's gotta be a way.
Let's keep on looking. That's what we came here for. We all agreed, and now we're here.
You think it's really possible?
Sure. Anything is.
There's no going back.
You don't think I know that?
Come on. That looks like an easier way to get where we're going.
Well, let's take it. Wouldn't want you to throw your back out climbing, old man.
You really are a charmer, aren't you?
After how many centuries?
Which is your house?
What do you mean, which is ours? All of them. They're all ours.
Yep. Everyone in the village lived together.
One big happy family?
One heck of a lot of places to hang your hat.
We're back.
So, you want to take a look around?
We'd better. Gotta find something to help us lose these brands.
That's not the only reason we're here. You're finally home. Make the most of it.
Is Aunt Blank for all this too?
Thank you.
Ragnarok. Come, day of wrath, O pulse the sea. Embrace thy fate, thine home to burn, that fallen souls might bear our plea to hasten the divine's return. O piteous wanderer, Ragnarok, make of this day a brave epoch. Deliver the divine. Ragnarok.
What?
Serah. How did you...
I was waiting for you to open your eyes. All the time I was asleep, I knew what was happening. I kept trying to think up a way to save Cocoon. Together.
Serah. Huh.
You get it now. There are no gods with miracles to save us. No matter where you look. That's why we have to call one. Destroy Orphan. We'll save the world.
Stop it!
You can't do that. You love me too much. You do, don't you, Claire?
Enough already! Listen up. We are all shooting for the same goal here.
And the result of that is this.
You son of a...
You betray your foul sea to chase after dreams and shadows. The world you claim to wish to protect now faces the end of days, with no hope of salvation.
I didn't think foul sea had the means.
Oh, it won't be foul sea who destroy her. For centuries now, Cocoon has provided generously for its human inhabitants every want and need. Coddled them, one might even say. The result being their deep-seated fear and hatred of change and all things alien. fed, nurtured, and ready to detonate at the slightest spark. The seeds of destruction take root, even now.
What did you do to Cocoon?
I resigned, appointing Reigns as Primarch in my stead.
Reigns? He's alive?
The puppet is restrung to serve my needs, yes. Its eyes had long since turned to glass. Of course, the cavalry's eyes will see our friend as nothing more than a traitor to their cause. They'll say the Falci got to him too, or some such drivel. And imagine, when I spread word that it's Orphan tugging at his strings, what happens next?
You're gonna use the cavalry to take the thing out?
Perhaps. Or perhaps I'll feign the howling of Pulsian wolves and let the fear-addled sheep slaughter themselves first. Either way, the end is at hand. But what of yourselves? Will you enjoy the festivities beside me? Or perhaps... greet the end here, in the land where it all began?
Arcanalus!
Fulfill your hopes and save your precious self. Destroy the world that despises you.
Yeah.
You struggle in vain.
Just do.
time has come. Allow me to extend my invitation. To save a people beyond salvation, there is only Ragnarok. Cocoon suffers. Release her from the pain.
What? So, this is the end of the rainbow, huh? Well, here's hoping the pot's full of tips on dealing with crackpot Falci.
You know, I don't remember this being here before. I guess it's new, huh?
Yeah, must be. I suppose it might be a record of what happened. You know, after we turned to crystal. Cocoon, where the slaves of Lindsay dwell, is the enemy of all life fostered by Pulse's sacred hand. So Al-Falsi determined Pulse's will, chose Lissi, and gave them a focus. Become Ragnarok and bring about the end of Cocoon. And so the beast arose, defeated Lindsay's hateful Falsi, and prepared to tear Cocoon apart. But her providence betrayed Alice, draining Ragnarok of strength. Their focus only half complete, the Lissi were taken to the enemy's land by Bartandalus, curse his name. And the goddess said, Lissi who rest upon Cocoon will reawaken, however long they may wait. And Ragnarok will rise again to tear the land from its seat in the sky. Her word is absolute.
Guess the jig is up. Cocoon's done for, isn't it?
Yeah, you don't sweat it. If we go ahead and smash Cocoon, you know some maker's sure to roll up and save the day.
As long as Falci are around, this fight is never gonna end. So let's finish it. Let's get Dysler.
So what do we do about Orphan?
We help Orphan. What else can we do? If we can manage to keep it safe...
Another war breaks out somewhere down the road. We're Lissi. It's not like we can make people stop fighting.
Lightning, you told me on Cocoon. It's not a question of can or can't. We just do it. That's our only choice this time. Maybe it won't do much. Maybe only one person will listen to us. But even then, isn't trying better than doing nothing?
Because ripples can make waves.
Okay, kids have gone crazy.
Revolutionaries always get called crazy.
When I was on Cocoon, I wished on those fireworks. I wished to not let anything happen to Cocoon this time. But I shouldn't have wished for that. Wishes aren't enough. Prayers either. This time I'm making a promise. I will keep Cocoon safe. I promise, no matter what.
I guess it takes losing everything to make you see how much you have to fight for.
And we're the only ones who can do it, right?
Right.
Yep. All right then. Let's tie up loose ends.
Okay.
Right.
All right.
Yeah. Shadows. Our minds were made up. We'd realized along the way that choice was the only thing we had left. Maybe we'd fall short. Maybe we'd never even come close. But someone, someday, would know we'd tried.
Your Eminence, it is time. The people await your address.
And so, we greet the new dawn.
People of Cocoon, my fellow citizens, we have survived the twilight and gather now to welcome the dawn of the day on which we decide our fate. Many are the lessons we have learned during our long night of hardship and sacrifice. And now we face choices, choices which must be made as our hearts dictate and not abandoned to uncaring chance. Let us forge ahead with unflinching courage and honor the fallen with action. With these hands, we shape the future.
Hi there.
Now!
You're dead!
You first!
Creatures is attacking the city. It's a pulse invasion force. Your Eminence, we must evacuate.
So, Reigns, is this the cocoon you dreamed of?
My dream is but a Falsey's fancy now.
Fresh off the ark, I'd wager.
This is out of control. What'll happen to Cocoon?
It's all out war.
Did we cause this by coming back? Or Tantalus's prediction? It's all coming true.
Well, his future stops right here. We're the ones who decide what happens next.
Let's get moving.
Right.
Okay.